Happy to have in studio the police chief for the city of Shelton, Darrin Moody. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm well. How are you?
It's a good day. It's Friday.
Yeah.
Week went well.
Yeah. Good week. We had the national night out was Tuesday night. There was a lot of neighborhoods that kind of gather, and this is a take back the streets kind of thing, or what's the deal with this?
Well, you know, we have good and bad with National Night Out this year.
Okay.
The good is we have three neighborhood watch groups, and a fourth one just contacted me the other day that wants to start.
Nice.
And we weren't able to get them all together for National Night Out this year, but, you know, one of them's having a party next Friday night. They decided, you know what, we'll have it in August. We just won't hit National Night Out, close off the streets, have a barbecue to meet all the neighbors and invite us over to come visit. But next year we anticipate getting them together on the same date and doing something like that.
I know there's a place, one of the neighborhoods out in Lacey, Horizon Point or something like that. It's a huge deal. Some 1,500 people come out, and the cops are there, and the law enforcement from all over,
yes,
they show up. It's a good deal to remind folks that, what, that the streets are theirs too? And
that's it, you know, and get to know your neighbors. That's what it's all about. You know, nowadays everybody's so busy running back and forth with commuting that nobody gets to know who their neighbors are.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice to know who your neighbors are and have people that you can rely on when you go out of town, or your people watching out for your neighbors. That's a good thing. And next year, what I'd like to do, instead of just doing it as a group at the Civic Center or something, have them have block parties at their blocks, and we'll come visit you.
Yeah, come around. Oh, man, that would be a lot of fun. So we'll keep our eyes on that one. What did you want to talk about today? I think you had to come on here for a...
I did have one thing.
Yeah.
As you know, Dr. Apostle and I are really excited about Graduation Matters Shelton,
mm-hmm,
moving that forward. And the young lady who is running the after-school program at Choice, Diva, will be running it again this year. And what we've tried to do is look for sponsors, folks that want to deliver food once a month, once a week, whatever they can do. Any businesses, nonprofits, whatever. Individuals, you know. A few times last year I dropped off pizza over there for them. And I've got one sponsor, Bacala State Farm.
Oh, yeah.
Has agreed that she, once a month, she'll drop off food for the kids over there, which is a good thing. So anybody who's interested in doing that, it's just a neat program. And the kids after school, it's to give them a chance to sit back, relax, do some homework, you know, be with their peers in a safe environment.
Mm-hmm.
It can be anything from pizza to Taco Bell to Burger King. We're not looking for healthy. We're just looking for food.
Yeah.
And let me know. Give me a call or shoot me an email, and we'll schedule you on the calendar for the next year.
All right. Very good. And it's not just Choice High School kids that go there. It's
absolutely
it's all
not.
Everybody.
Yeah. It's the entire school district. Choice just happened to be the central location in a downtown area.
Yeah.
And, you know, who knows? It's probably going to expand to other schools, as Dr. Apostle and I have talked about. But we'd like to kickstart it there. Last year, they averaged probably 15 kids a day after school. This year, I anticipate it'll be a little bit bigger, because last year was kind of the soft opening.
Yeah.
So it'll be fun.
How are things going with the road diet on Railroad? Are you guys hearing any reports of anything?
It's interesting. You know, a lot of what we're hearing is just change.
Yeah.
And, you know, I've noticed downtown that people are slowing down a little bit. Mostly because they're not used to it.
They're
just trying to figure it out. If it slows traffic down and makes it safer for the folks downtown, absolutely.
Yeah.
If it gives them a chance to shop a little more, that's a great thing, too. Everybody likes change until it affects them. And so we've had some people calling in saying, you know, I don't like it. Or we, on the flip side, we've had folks calling in saying, this is wonderful. In fact, we had a couple of our own staff saying, you know, the neatest thing about it was just seeing the brightness in downtown.
Yeah.
Just brightening it up and cleaning it up,
mm-hmm,
just makes a huge difference.
Yeah, even just the fresh coat of paint on the streets.
And I really like the non-stick, or the, I guess, stick.
Yeah.
In the crosswalks.
Yeah, it's like a brick color.
Yeah, it's like a rubberized. I think that's a great idea for wintertime up here, people walking across the street.
Yeah, I didn't even think about that.
Yeah.
That's a good one. Yesterday I was talking about the Renton Police Department, the first in the state to start using drones to help investigate crimes. How does this work out? How do you get... I mean, this isn't like you go to the toy store and you buy a drone. This has to be probably something sanctioned and official.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, sure, I could go down to Walmart and buy a, you know, helicopter to fly over and do those things. There's certain legal ramifications we have to work within. And I think a lot of that's being worked out. I mean, if you look back 15, 20 years ago, who'd have thought we'd have body cameras?
True, yeah.
And the state's still working on that. We tend to get ahead of ourselves sometimes, and we get excited. I think body cameras and the car cameras are an outstanding idea. I think they're great. The drawback is there's the legislation back and forth as to who gets to view this.
Yeah.
And that's where it becomes overwhelming for us. For us, it's a great tool, and it helps us eliminate 90% of the complaints that come through when people actually see themselves on video.
Yeah.
But the flip side is people come in and inundate us with public records requests. And, you know, I have some personal and professional views on it of, does everybody get to view when I go to Jeff's house on a call?
Sure.
You know, I think that should be, personally, I think it should be limited to the folks involved in the call. Or, you know, if it's a major incident, the media, absolutely. But we'll fight through those. And I think the drones is the same way. You know, it's just another tool.
It seems like it would be, I get what you're saying, because I know when we've had Under Sheriff Barrett on from the Sheriff's Department on, talking about how much time is needed to be dedicated to watch, because it's a minute. Every minute of live video is a minute you have to watch it to make sure you scrub the people's faces. I can see how this would be a good thing and a bad thing for smaller police departments, so you can get in,
right,
get your crime photos and get a 3D image of the whole area and then get out of there quickly to start your reports. But on the other side, then you got all these people, then you have to look through the videos and mm-hmm. stuff like that.
And, you know, if juveniles involved.
Sure.
You know, victims of crime involved, things like that we've got to edit. We have in-car cameras, but, you know, even those, they're getting older. And, you know, sometimes they're working, sometimes they're not. We don't have a dedicated IT person at the police department.
Oh.
We have an IT in the city that's doing great things, you know, moving ahead with the website and some other ideas, and I think we'll move forward. But it's an interesting tool, and it's for us, it's beneficial.
Something totally new. I when you're probably going through the academy again, like the body cameras, you never thought of this ever.
Who thought we'd have little tiny cameras attached to us and we could see everything around us?
Yeah.
And, you know, it's the perspective that people get is different. You know, you talk to five people at a crime scene and you get usually five different versions of what went on,
mm-hmm.
slightly different. This way, you've got an actual version of what occurred.
Yeah, very good. Well, Chief Moody, have a great weekend.
You too.
Thanks for coming in.
It should be a sunny, nice weekend.
I hope so.
I hope so.
We'll
see. You enjoy.
Thank you. 722 at iFiber One News Radio. We'll be right back after this.
Hey, what do you have planned this weekend?